2017, and I just received my Aqua Eye marine boat monitoring system. Now, if you're not familiar with the Aqua Eye, this is a wireless boat monitoring system. And what it will do is it will send text messages to up to 3 users on the status of your boat. And I'll just go over what the system entails here. This is the main base unit here. And this is the 12 volt power monitor. So you can plug this into the 12 volt power outlet or a cigarette lighter, and it keeps an eye on your DC voltage. I'm going to wire mine directly to the batteries as it's recommended. If your boat has shore power, you'd plug this into an outlet and it'll let you know if your boat loses its shore power. This is the high water float sensor here. And so you place this someplace probably close to your bilge pump. And if the water exceeds the point where this float goes up in that position, it will send a wireless message to this, and then this sends a message to your sends via text to whatever users you want. This one is for the door, and so this is the part that goes on the door, and this is the transmitter that sends a message again back to the base unit, and then the base unit sends you a text message and said, now the door's been open. Comes with a key fob, so you can activate it by doing the key or key fob, or you can send it a text message to activate as well. And it came with 4 batteries. And these 2 batteries go on this transmitter, and 2 batteries go on this transmitter, and this is powered by your 12 volt power source. Oh, and they sent me some extra brochures that I think they'd like me to pass out. But Aqua Eye Marine, they're out of the Minneapolis area. And then they also sent me some instructions. So, Aqua Eye Marine Boat Monitoring System. It's wireless, pretty simple to install. And now I've gone over the basics of it. And this is everything that came in the box. I will make a video on putting in the different sensors. Okay, we've got part 2 of the Aqua Eye boat monitoring system installation here, and I'm in the engine room of the yacht that I work on. Nice thing about the Aqua Eye is it works great for a yacht of this size, which is 80 feet, but you could work great on a ski boat that is, you know, 20 feet or even smaller. So this Aqua Eye system is nice because it offers a lot of different type vessels a solution to keep an eye on their boat when they're not there. So I've showed you all this stuff in the earlier segment. Now over here, my batteries, and I'm going to be hooking up the DC monitoring part of the Aqua Eye system to those. I'm going to go directly, and this part screws right into that outlet there. I've just taken it off because I'm going to hardwire this to my batteries because I don't have a 12 volt outlet down here. But if you're on a small ski boat or something like that, you can just plug this right into your 12 volt power outlet they charge your phones with, you know, and just mount the unit under your helm or dash. Now, luckily for me, right close to the batteries, I also have a power outlet right there, and I'm going to be plugging in the AC power monitor to that outlet, and I'm going to mount the unit right down there. That hole is already there, but it looks like I've got a perfect spot to mount this unit right down in there. And here's the high water monitor. I'll show you where I'm going to mount that. I'm going to go forward here, and way down in there, that's where my forward bilge pump is. I think I'm just going to mount it right down there in the low spot, or close to the low spot. So that way if that area starts to fill up with water, and for some reason the bilge pump doesn't kick on, then I will be able to, I'll get a text message saying I've got water down there. So that's part 2, and once I start getting everything installed here, I'll put up part 3. Okay, we're going to start the third segment of our Aqua Eye installation video here. You can see I've got the Aqua Eye mounted to the bulkhead there. I just used 2 screws to screw it in. Use the level to make sure it's nice and square, but you don't have to. Now this is the AC power monitor, and it's plugged into the bottom part of the Aqua Eye there. And I just ran it up through this wire loom here, and it's going to go right to this outlet in there. And for just for illustration purposes, what I've done is I've got this 12 volt outlet that's connected to two battery clips. And what you would do, just pretend that's your 12 volt power source on your dash or helm of your small ski boat or runabout or something like that. I'm just going to plug it in. Now this is doing the exact same thing as a hard, because I'm going to hardwire mine right to those batteries. Then you would take the clip there and you would just plug it into the upper socket there. It just screws in. It's really simple, but I just wanted to show how most people will probably be connecting their power 12 volt power source. Like I said, I've just got positive, negative, and red is good, black is bad, negative. So that's how it'd go. But I'm gonna take the end of this cable off here. You see red and black there. Red is good, black is bad, negative. And I'm gonna actually go to the battery terminals directly. And I've got a 24 volt system where most boats are only gonna have 12 volt, but I'm not gonna get into that. So, but just wanted to kind of give a demonstration process how simple it is to hook up the power. All right, this is segment 4. I've got the main Aqua unit installed in the engine room. Now I've got to put the batteries in the wireless transmitters. And so here is the high water transmitter. It just has two Phillips screws on the back, which I've already undone. And it's got the battery compartment there. And just put battery 1 in, and battery 2 in. And they both go the same direction. It's a little different than you might see on other small battery operated devices, but they both go in the same direction. And then we'll just put the battery cover on the back. It's hard to do kind of one-handed there holding the camera. And I'll just tighten those Phillips head screws in. And then I'm going to do the same on this one. We've got two Phillips screws. I'll undo those. And this is the door alarm or the door transmitter. So I'm going to take the back off of that, put two screws in there. Up here, I've got the intrusion sensor mounted. And it's similar to what you probably see in a lot of home security devices. This is the transmitter, and then this is the magnet that goes on the door. And when the door is opened, it should indicate that the door is open. You'll get an intrusion alert text message sent to your phone. I just got one popped up on my screen here, so it worked. And I didn't use screws here because this is chrome metal. This is the main entrance. So I just used the 3M command strips. And I'm not telling you what to do, but I don't want to drill holes in this metal. So that way they come off easy and not damage this nice shiny metal. But I did use screws on the bulkhead to secure the main base unit. All right, well, I've got everything installed. I got my cover back in my battery box. You can see that red and black wire down there. That's going to my batteries, which are hardwired into the Aqua Eye. There's the Aqua Eye unit there. So if I get down here, you can see it's blinking red, kind of about the same rate as a heartbeat. That means it's functioning correctly. As you give power to the system, it goes through a series of flashes, which you can read about in the instructions. Once it gets to this normal heartbeat status, that means it's functioning properly. Got my AC sensor plugged in there. Forward here in the engine room. Down there I've got my high water sensor. And then up here I've got my transmitter for the high water sensor. And I showed you the intrusion sensor, which is working properly. Everything seems to be working properly. See if I can do some screenshots of the status updates it gives me. There you can send it different commands and it'll tell you different things, but overall it's pretty simple to install. It took me less than an hour with camera work and everything. Only thing I used was a level to level my base unit correctly. I used a drill. You don't have to. You could just get by the screwdriver, but I'd say if you know how to use a screwdriver, that's about all you really need to use. You can use the drill, like I said, to make it maybe a little bit faster. But overall, so far, so good, and everything works fine. Aqua Eye did not give me this unit. I paid full retail price, and also the data fee for the year, I think $199 is what I paid. And so far, so good. If I have any other updates, I will let everyone know. If you have any questions, send me a message via YouTube. I'll put a link to the Aqua Eye site if you want to send them a message or maybe buy one. You buy it via their site directly, and it goes through PayPal. Really simple process. So, like everything else, pretty simple. Clean those wires up a little bit with some zip ties, but I'll take care of that next. So, Happy New Year. Let me know if you have any questions. Hopefully you enjoyed my installation video of the Aqua Eye.